Hi guys, Nick Jennings from Guitar Interactive. Today we're taking a look at the Jared James Nichols signature Blues Power Les Paul from our friends at Epiphone. This is the third edition of Jared's signature Les Paul from Epiphone, but it is much more than just a colour swap, although it is gorgeous in this beautiful satin Pelham blue, which feels really nice and looks absolutely spectacular, I'm sure you will agree. But it's much more than that. We also have significant updates in the form of the tuners and the pickup, and we're going to talk more about those in just a second. But first, let's take a listen to this guitar once again. Now, in the intro, you heard us playing through a load of gain through our Victory Super Kraken, playing some blues rock leads. I used as much finger as I could. I wasn't brave enough to ditch the pick entirely. Let's switch over to a clean sound. We'll ditch the backing track and all the reverb and delay, and let's take a listen to this guitar in its purest form. And then when we come back, we'll talk more about the spec. So now we've heard this guitar play clean and play dirty, let's talk more about the spec, starting, as we always do, at the headstock. So starting in the headstock, we have this really attractive open book headstock design with a black painted headstock and 7-ply binding that nods to the Les Paul customs that inspired this guitar. We also appear to have Grover Rotomatics like the previous models, but if we flip it over, let me show you this. This is a significant update for the Blues Power model. These are locking Grover Rotomatics, which is a really nice touch. Now you might be thinking, why do I need locking tuners on a guitar that doesn't have a trem? Well, it does improve tuning stability, but it also speeds up string change just like you've no idea. And these are really robust feeling tuners in a really nice brushed satin nickel finish. Looks very premium. They feel nice and heavy. They add a little bit of mass to the guitar, which if you subscribe to this sort of thing, may add some sustain. You are free to agree or disagree with that, depending upon your personal biases. But either way, they feel very, very nice. They also function really, really well. So it's a nice addition. We also have Jared's signature around here on the back, which is great because we don't like guitars that have too much of that signature-itis going on. This is a nice subtle nod to the artist who this guitar is designed for. We can also get a look at the back of the neck, which is finished in, it says it's finished in gloss, but this feels like more like kind of a satin to me. So it's almost like a worn satin. It's a very, very tactile finish. Feels absolutely gorgeous. And of course, this blue looks wonderful. It's kind of iridescent as you turn it to and forward in the light. It looks absolutely fabulous. Let's flip it back over and take a look at the fretboard. Now the fretboard is ebony, which is really nice, with 22 medium jumbo frets on a 50s profile neck. Now this is quite a large neck, but it's not big and cumbersome like some of the 70s customs where the neck was almost as thick as the body. And you can definitely get your thumb behind the neck and do some fast shreddy antics if you want to, and the larger fret profile really helps with that too. But it's still meaty enough if you're the kind of player that likes to really wrestle the guitar like Jared does. Now Jared is a large man with large hands. I'm a pretty big guy too, and it feels very, very comfortable for that sort of thing. If you have smaller mitts, that may be less so, but I still don't think it's big enough to be cumbersome even for smaller players. Really, really nice. Now, what we do have, which is kind of interesting, is we have block inlays that finish on 15, and we also don't have any side dots for the typical 17, 19, 21. It is a little confusing to begin with, but you get used to it very quickly, although I would have probably included some side dots myself. That's a very minor criticism, and it's quite easy to navigate this guitar just by feel, but even still, that is one thing where I'm like, if I could change anything, it would probably be that. But that is real small fry. Now, let's take a look at the body. Now, the body is your typical Les Paul custom shape with this lovely arched top, and it's all mahogany, so there's no maple cap here, which, again, does have a certain effect on the tone. It's going to focus the sound more into the mid-range, but that's offset by this P90 pickup that we'll talk about in a second. Now, it's gorgeously finished in this, I think it's a satin-feeling Pelham blue. It's labeled as gloss. It feels more satin to me, but that's a good thing because it feels really nice and tactile, a little like if you've taken a satin guitar and played it in for a very long time. This is kind of what it feels like. Now that continues onto the back and the sides, and we also have the same 7-ply binding, which is really luxurious and very, very cool looking. I'm just going to show you the back very quickly. We have the same finish. The back is of course flat, as you'd expect from a Les Paul type guitar. Very, very comfortable. Again, the same satin finish, control cavity there. Let's flip it back over and take a good look at the front. Now this is where one of the most significant updates to the Blues Power JJN signature has been made, as opposed to the Gold Glory and the Old Glory, and it's in the form of the pickup. This is Jared's signature Seymour Duncan Silencer P90, and it's a noiseless P90. Now this is really useful because this pickup is set quite a long way away from the strings, and it's quite a low output pickup to begin with, so there's not a lot of output coming out of this guitar. It's very much a vintage low output style instrument, and that can be a problem if you have a P90 that kind of garners a lot of noise. If it's susceptible to hum, then you can end up with a situation, especially if you're gunning the amp like Jared likes to, you might get the situation where you have almost as much noise as you do signal. That is not the case here, because this is whisper quiet but still has all of the dynamics and tone and wiriness that we love from a good P90. Very, very great sounding pickup. Absolutely love this. It's a nice addition, and again adds a little bit more versatility in terms of the situations that you can use this guitar. You're not going to fall foul of, say, a bad lighting rig, for example, which is, you know, a real concern. We also have the return of the lightning intonated wraparound tailpiece. This is a real nice touch. Again, it's finished in satin nickel, which feels and looks very premium. Master volume, master tone, and that's your whack as far as sounds go. Now, that sounds like it may be a little restricted, but in actual fact, there's a ton of tones that you can get from just this very simple configuration if you're willing to play with the volume and the tone control, which is what we're going to do next. So let's go to channel one on our Super Kraken, which is a British gold panel inspired tone. We're going to explore exactly how many sounds we can get out of just this one pickup position using our volume and our tone control. So as you can hear, we can get a load of great sounds out of one amp channel using just our volume and tone control, and that's before we even discuss things like pick position, fingers versus pick, pick dynamics, etc. So plenty of versatility, even though we have just one pickup selection to choose from. What surprised me the most is how good the clean sound is, and I think that's down to the premium CTS pots, which are allowing us to retain quite a lot of top end as we roll our volume down. Really, really nice. We can also get almost kind of a pseudo jazz sound by going to that clean sound, rolling our tone control back, which, when we wind our volume control up, gives us this really lovely, convincing woman tone, which is really, really excellent. Again, tons of versatility there, despite having just one pickup, and there's no noise, which is another really nice touch. Now, next up, let's do some more situational examples, and we're going to begin with a type of sound that you wouldn't necessarily associate with this guitar, which is a beautiful ambient clean. So for this, I'm going to throw on my favorite compressor with a little bit of high-end boost, some reverb and delay from my Strymon Timeline in Big Sky. We'll go to the clean channel on the Super Kraken. Let's take a listen to that. Next up, we're going to wind ourselves a little further up the gain range, we'll turn the compressor off, we'll turn the gain up on our clean channel, and we'll throw on a TS type boost and some slapback delay, and take a listen to how this guitar sounds with some slide. Now, one of my favorite applications for a great P90 is with a vintage style fuzz. And for this, we're gonna throw on a Fuzz Face style fuzz into the clean sound cranked on our Super Kraken. Now, this is a really great combination because it's quite a warm sounding clean, and the fuzz itself is a little bit hairy in the top end, but it responds really well to guitars with a wiry character like this P90. And this guitar really retains its character very well through thick layers of fuzz. Now, there's not a whole lot of output here, so we are gonna have to gun the output and maybe turn the fuzz up to get a convincing saturation, but it does sound absolutely killer. And there's something about a low output pickup that's placed a little further away from the strings that retains so much character and airiness. It's a really, really great sound. We'll also play with the tone control some more and see what effect that has on our fuzz tone. Now, speaking of gain sounds, we've already heard this guitar with a Larry blues rock lead tone and also a classic gold panel British tone. I know you guys are gonna ask, so we're gonna switch this across to the American voiced gain 2 on our Super Kraken. We'll throw on a TS type boost, we'll go through a Mesa Boogie cab with a vintage 30 and a 57. We'll down tune a little bit and we'll see how well our blues power Jared James Nichols signature guitar handles some metal. So it is a stitch of work to keep those sounds tight with the low output P90, but if your chops are up to it, this guitar sounds absolutely killer for metal riffing applications. Now, again, the thing that sets this guitar apart from previous JJN signatures is the pickup and the fact that the pickup is noiseless, which means we can use this with gobs and gobs of gain. To that end, let's see how much gain we can dial up for a shred approved lead sound. We're gonna stick with channel 2 on the Super Kraken, and we'll go to some green backs for our cab, and we'll throw on the TS boost once again, have a little bit of a play with the settings, and dial in perhaps even more saturation for a liquid lead tone. Not the easiest tone in the world to dial up with a low output P90 that's set far away from the strings, but given that this pickup is noiseless and has such excellent performance with high gain sounds, it's a bit of a breeze. Now, you do need a lot of gain on tap with your amp to dial up this tone with this particular guitar, but luckily we've got tons of gain available, so we might as well throw it on and see how it sounds. So there you go, guys. That's been a look at the Jared James Nichols Blues Power Signature Les Paul from our friends at Epiphone. It is a worthy successor to two absolutely excellent signature models that have come before it in the form of the Old Glory and the Gold Glory. But for my money, this is not just the best looking of the three, but also the best performing of the three, thanks to that noiseless P90, which sounds absolutely excellent and cleans up beautifully with the volume control. Also, the Grover Rotomatics, the locking Rotomatics rather, are a really nice touch. They help keep the tuning stability absolutely rock solid. They had a little bit of mass, which actually improves the balance of the guitar somewhat as well, because it's quite a heavy instrument. It's not hugely cumbersome by any stretch of the imagination, but it has got some heft to it, and having a little bit of weight and a machine head really helps too. But also, again, that's going to speed up your string changes and it keeps the tuning really, really tight, which is nice. But more importantly, the guitar looks fantastic. It plays exceptionally well. It's surprisingly versatile for a single pickup guitar with a single P90, no coil splits, no taps, no phase reverse or anything like that. Just one pickup and the truth, but you can do loads and loads of sounds with this guitar, as I'm sure you've heard over the course of this review. So really impressive stuff once again from Epiphone and Jared James Nichols. Just to remind you, this is the Blues Power Jared James Nichols signature Les Paul from our friends at Epiphone. My name is Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive Magazine. I'll see you next time.